Hello students, I am Manoj Kundare, the assistant professor of electronic science. Welcome back to our e-learning platform. In this video, we are going to start the paper 2nd of semester 1st of FIBSC Computer Science. The name of the subject is Principle of Digital Electronics. Let's start the unit 1st of this subject named as Number System and Digital Codes. Let's start our today's topic. Introduction to the number system. There are different types of number systems such as decimal number system, binary number system, octal number system, and hexadecimal number system. Let's see the decimal number system. In decimal number system, we used total 10 symbols such as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. That means up to 0 to 9. There are total 10 symbols, hence its base or radix of the decimal number system is 10. In binary number system, we use the total 2 symbols, 0 and 1, hence the base or radix of the binary number system is 2. In octal number system, we use total 8 symbols, 0 to 7, hence its base or radix is 8. And in hexadecimal number system, we use total 16 symbols, hence its base or radix is 16. The 16 symbols are the numbers from 0 to 9 and the alphabets from A to F. Okay, 0 to 9 and from A to F. Let's see, once again, the binary number system has the base 2. Hence, it has only 2 symbols, 0 and 1. Octal number system has base or radix 8. Hence, it has the symbols 0 to 7. Decimal number system has base or radix 10. Hence, it uses the symbol 0 to 9. And hexadecimal number system has the base or radix 16. Hence, it uses the digits 0 to 9 and the alphabets A to F. This is the table shows the decimal equivalent of binary, octal and hexadecimal. In decimal number system, we know that this number system from our childhood, that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. After 9, we get the number 10 as 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Similarly, in binary number, we get 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0010 up to 1111. Okay. In octal number system, we get the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. After 7, there is no 8, 9 in the octal number system. After 7, we get the number 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and so on. And in hexadecimal number system, we know that we use the symbols from 0 to 9, and after 9, we use the alphabet A, B, C, D, E, F. That means alphabet A is equivalent to the decimal 10, alphabet B is equal to decimal equivalent 12, alphabet F is equivalent to the decimal 15. Okay, we need this chart at the every stage of this chapter. Hence, look carefully at this chart and make practice it. Okay, now let's see the representation of the decimal number in the power of its base. That means its power of 10. For example, represent the decimal number 523.86 with the power of its base. Let's write down the number 532.82. First of all, write the powers at the left hand side of this decimal point. We have to place the power 0, 1 and power 2. At the right hand side, we have to place the power minus 1 and minus 2. Okay. Now, multiply this power of base with the coefficient. Hence, 5 into 10 raised to 2, 3 into 10 raised to 1, 2 into 10 raised to 0, 8 into 10 raised to minus 1, and 6 into 10 raised to minus 2. Similarly, we can represent the binary number in the power of its base 2. For example, represent the binary number 101.01 with the power of its base, that means its power of 10. First of all, write the number 101.01. We know that at the left hand side of the binary point or the decimal point, we have to place power 0, 1, 2, and at the right hand side, we have to place minus 1, minus 2. Then simply multiply the coefficient with the power of bits as 1 into 2 raised to 2, 0 into 2 raised to 1, 1 into 2 raised to 0, 0 into 2 raised to minus 1, 1 into 2 raised to minus 2. Okay, now let's see the representation of the octal number in the power of its base 8. For example, represent the octal number 426.35 with the power of its base. First of all, write down the number 426.35. Then write down its power left hand side of the decimal number 0, 1, 2 power. Right hand side we have power of minus 1, minus 2. Now multiply the coefficient with the base power, that means 4 into 8 raised to 2, 2 into 8 raised to 1, 6 into 8 raised to 0, 3 into 8 raised to minus 1, 5 into 8 raised to minus 2. Similarly, we can represent the hexadecimal number with the power of its base 16. For example, represent the hexadecimal number A2B.05 with the power of its base. First of all, write down the number 82B.05. Okay, left hand side of the decimal point the power is 012. Right hand side we have the power minus 1, minus 2. Now simply multiply the coefficient with the base power, that means A into 16 raised to 2, 2 into 16 raised to 1, B into 16 raised to 0, 0 into 16 raised to minus 1, and 5 into 16 raised to minus 2. Okay, I hope you all understand how to represent a given number into its power. Let's see the next topic, interconversion between the number system. The first conversion is other to decimal conversion. It further classified into three types, such as binary to decimal conversion, octal to decimal conversion, and hexadecimal to the decimal conversion. The next type of conversion is decimal to the other conversion. It has also three types, decimal to binary conversion, decimal to octal conversion, and decimal to hexadecimal conversion. The next type of conversions are binary to hexadecimal conversion and hexadecimal to binary conversion. Let's see each type one by one. First of all, let's see other to the decimal conversion. The steps of the other to the decimal conversion are, first step is note down the given number. Second step is write down the weights for the different position. Third step is multiply each digit in the given number with the corresponding power of base. And the fourth step is add all product terms to get the decimal equivalent. Let's see it on example. First of all, let's see the conversion of binary to decimal conversion. The example is that convert the binary number 1011.01 into its decimal equivalent. Okay, it is very simple. That means we have to represent this number into its power of base. That means 1011.01. First of all, we have to write the power of base. That means at the left hand side, we have the power 0, 1, 2, 3. At right hand side, we have the power minus 1, minus 2. Then we have to write this power or the product term, such as this coefficient 1 into this power, that means 2 raised to 3, like this way. Let's see this. Okay. After writing all the power, we get 1 into 2 raised to 3, 0 into 2 raised to 2, 1 into 2 raised to 1, 1 into 2 raised to 0, 0 into 2 raised to minus 1, and 1 into 2 raised to minus 2. After multiplication, we get the result as 2 raised to 3 means 8, 2 raised to 2 means 4, 2 raised to 1 means 2, 2 raised to 0 means 0. We have to know that a raised to 0 is equal to 1. Hence, 2 raised to 0 is equal to 1. 2 raised to minus 1 means 0.5. 2 raised to minus 2 means 0.25. When we make the product, we get the numbers as 1 into 8, we get 8. 0 into 4, we get 0, and so on. After multiplication, we add all the sum and we get 11.25. That means the 11.25 is the decimal equivalent of the number 1011.01. Similarly, we can convert the octal number into its decimal equivalent. Okay. For example, convert the octal number 365.24 into its decimal equivalent. We have the octal number 365.24. First of all, write the base power, that means at the left hand side we place 0 power 1, 2, right hand side we place minus 1, minus 2. And after this, we represent the number as 3 into 8 raised to 2, 6 into 8 raised to 1, 5 into 8 raised to 0, 2 into 8 raised to minus 1, and 4 into 8 raised to 2. Okay. Now, the next step is, the next step is 8 square means 64, 8 raised to 1 means 8, 8 raised to 0 means 1, 8 raised to minus 1 means 0.125, 8 raised to minus 2 means 0.015625. Okay. After the product of 3 into 64, we get 192, 6 into 8, we get 48, 5 into 1, we get 5, 2 into 0.125, we get 25, and so on. Then this sum gives us the number 245. This sum gives us the number 245.31. Okay, this is the decimal equivalent of the octal number 365.24. Similarly, we can convert the hexadecimal number into its decimal equivalent. Okay, let's see it on an example. Convert the hex number 4C8.2 into its decimal equivalent. We have the number 4C8.2. Write down its power 0, 1, 2, and here is minus 1. Okay. Then simply represent it 4 into 16 raised to 2. Okay. C into 16 raised to 1. 8 into 16 raised to 0, 2 into 16 raised to 1. Okay, now here the C is appear, we have to write the decimal equivalent of C in place of C, hence we write 12 in place of C. Now, after the simplification, we get the number as 1024.125. This is the decimal equivalent of the hexadecimal 4C8.2. I hope you all understand this type of conversion. Now, let's see the second type of conversion, decimal to the other conversion. First of all, let's see the steps of the decimal to the other conversion. The first step is note down the given number. The second step is if the given number consists of a decimal point, then we have to first separate out the integer and the fractional part. Then convert them differently to the desired radix or base and combine the converted parts to obtain the complete converted number. Okay, let's see this on an example. First of all, let's see the conversion decimal to the binary conversion. The example is convert 105 decimal to the equivalent binary number. In this number 105, there is no decimal point. Hence, this is the only integer part, and when we convert the integer decimal into its equivalent binary or octal or hexadecimal, then we have to divide its to we have to divide this number by the base. That means when we have to convert the decimal integer into the binary integer, then we have to divide it by 2. If we want to convert decimal integer into octal integer, we have to divide it by 8. And if we want to convert the decimal integer into the hexadecimal integer, then we have to divide it 16. Okay. Now write down the given number 105, and we have to convert it into binary. Hence, divide this 105 number by the base. Now we get the result as, here is the result of this division is as, like that. We get the quotient as 52, hence write 52 here and the remainder as 1 here. Okay, now again divide this 52 number by 2. We get, again divide this 52 number by 2, we get (26) as the quotient and 0 as the remainder. Hence, write the 26 number here and quotient 0 as here. Now again divide this 26 by 2, we get 13 as the quotient and the remainder is 0. Hence, put 13 here and remainder here. Now again divide this 13 by 2, we get 6 as the quotient. That means 6 into 2, 12. 13 minus 12, we get 1 here. Again, this divide 6 by 2, we get 3 as a quotient and 0 as a remainder. After continuing this process, we get the remainders as 1101001. Here is, at the bottom we have MSB and at the top we have LSB. Hence, write this number in opposite manner or in the reverse manner, is that 1101001 1101001. We get the binary equivalent. Similarly, we can convert the decimal number into its octal number. Okay, we have the integer part here, 204. Simply divide this 204 by 8. We get the result of the division as like this. Okay, here is the quotient is 25, hence we place 25 here, and the remainder is 4, we place 4 here. Then now again divide this 25 number by 8, we get 8 into 3, we get 24. 25 minus 24, we get 1. Hence, we place the quotient 3 as here and remainder 1 as here. Okay. Similarly, we have to divide this 3 by 8. We get the quotient as 0 and the remainder as 3. Hence, we place the quotient here and the remainder here. We get the number 413. But we have the MSB at the bottom and LSB at the top. Hence, the number is 314. Okay, that means the decimal 204 is equivalent to the octal 314. Similarly, we can convert the decimal to hexadecimal conversion. Okay, convert the 259 decimal number into the equivalent hexadecimal number. First of all, write down the number 259, divide it by 16, we get the quotient as 16 and remainder as 3. Now this 16 is again divided by 16, we get the quotient as 1 and the remainder as 0. Again this 1 is divided by 16, we get the quotient as 0 and remainder as 1. Write down this number in reverse direction, we get the number 103. Okay, we get the number 103. I hope you all understand how to convert the integer part of the decimal number system into its equivalent other number system. Now let's see the fractional part of the number system, or how to convert the fractional decimal number into its fractional equivalent other number system. First of all, let's see the example. Convert the 0.42 decimal into the equivalent binary number. In integer decimal number system, or when we convert integer decimal number into its equivalent other number system, then we have to divide the number. But when we convert the fractional number, then we have to multiply the number. Okay, in this example, we have to convert the 0.42 into its equivalent binary number. Hence, we have to multiply by the base of the binary. That means we have to multiply it by 2. Okay, now the steps are very simple. Write down the first number 0.42, multiply it by base, that means 2. We get the multiplication as 0.84. The carry of this multiplication is 0, hence put outside it. The remaining number is 0.84. Multiply it by 2, we get the result 1.68. We get the result 1.68. Here is the carry is 1. Put 1 outside. The remaining number is 0.68. This 0.68 is again multiplied by 2. We get the result 1.36. The carry is 1. Place it outside. The remaining number is 0.36. Multiply it by 2. We get the number 0.72. The carry is 0. Place it outside. The remaining number is 0.72 into 2. Multiply it 2. We get the number 1.44. The carry is 1. Place it outside. Okay. After taking the carries, we get the carry section as like this. Okay. In this carry section, the top number is the MSB and the bottom number is the LSB. That means opposite process in the integer conversion. Okay, hence we have to write down this number in this direction. That means 01101, and this is 0.42. Hence we have to place 0.01101. Okay, I hope you all understand the conversion. Similarly, we can convert the decimal to octal conversion such that, for example, let's see, convert 0.61 decimal to its equivalent octal number. Write down the given decimal number 0.61. We have to convert in octal number, hence multiply it by 8. We get the product as 4.88. The carry is 4. Place it outside. The remaining number is 0.88. Hence, again, multiply the 0.88 with 8. We get the number 7.04. We have the carry for 7, hence place it outside. Okay, the remaining number is 0.054. Multiply it by 8, we get the number 0.32. Here is carry 0, place the carry outside. The remaining number is 0.32. Again, 0.32 is multiplied by 8, we get the number 2.56. The carry is 2. Place it outside. Okay, the carry is 2. Place it outside. The remaining number is 0.56. Again, multiply this number by 8. We get the number 4.48. Place the carry outside. Okay, by this way, we get the carry. Okay, the top number is the MSB and the bottom is the LSB. Hence, write down in this direction. We get the octal number as 0.47024. Okay. Similarly, we can convert the decimal to hexadecimal conversion. For example, let's see, convert the 0.122 decimal to equivalent X number. The procedure is similar. That means we have to multiply it by the base. The base of the hexadecimal number is 16. That means, first of all, multiply 0.122 into 16, we get 1.952. Place the carry outside and the remaining number is 0.952. Again multiply it by 16, we get the number 15.232. Place the carry outside, the carry is 15. Hence, we place the 15 outside, the remaining number is 0.232. Again, this 232 is multiplied by 16, we get the number and we continue the procedure till the fifth position. Okay. Now we have the carry 1, 15, 3, 11, 6. But we have to convert it into hexadecimal number and 15 is the decimal number. Hence, we have to find the equivalent hexadecimal of 15 and the equivalent hexadecimal of the 15 is F. Okay, similarly the equivalent hexadecimal of the 11 is B. Hence we get the number 1F3B6. 1F3B6. Okay, I hope you all understand how to convert the fractional part of the decimal number into its equivalent other number systems. If the integer and fractional parts are come together, then what procedures should follow? Let's see on this example. Convert the 31.32 decimal number into its equivalent binary number. First of all, let separate the decimal part or the integer part and the fractional part. The decimal or integer part is 31 and the fractional part is 0.32. Now let's separate it or make the separate conversion. We know that the decimal part should be converted by the division process and fractional part is converted by the multiplication process. Okay, the decimal part is 31, divide it by 2, we get the quotient as 15 and remainder as 1. Again divide this 15 by 2, we get the 7 as the quotient and the remainder as the 1. Again this 7 is divided by 2, we get the quotient as 3 and the remainder as 1. Again the 3 is divided by 2, we get the quotient as 1 and remainder as 1. This 1 is divided by 2, we get the quotient as 0 and remainder as the 1. Here is MSB at the bottom and LSB at the top. Hence write this number in this direction 11111. Okay, this is the conversion of the decimal part. But in the fractional part, we have to multiply by the base. Hence, the fractional part is 0.32. Multiply it by 2, we get 0.64. The carry is 0, place it outside. The remaining number is 0.64. Multiply it by 2, we get the number 1.28. Here is carry is 1, place it outside. The remaining number is 0.28. Again, this 0.28 is multiplied by 2. And we get the multiplication and this process is done up to fifth position. Okay, then we get the carry as 01011. Okay, we have MSB at the top and LSB at the bottom. These are the opposite in nature. That means here we done division process, here we done multiplication. Here the MSB at the bottom, here MSB at the top. Here LSB at the top, here LSB at the bottom. That means we get the number 0.01010, 0.01010. Okay, now combine this result, we get the equivalent decimal number. That means 31.32 is equivalent to 11111.0100. Okay. Similarly, we can see one example here. Convert 2003.31 to equivalent hexadecimal number. The procedure is similar. That means separate out the decimal or integer part and the fractional part. The decimal part is 2003 and fractional part is 0.31. In decimal part, divide by 16, we get the number 2003 divided by 16, we get the quotient as 125 and the remainder as 3. Okay, now again divide 125 by 16, we get quotient as 7 and remainder as 13. Again this 7 is divided by 16, we get the, here is the mistake. Okay, again the 7 number is divided by 16, we get the quotient as 0 and the remainder as 7. We get the number 3, 13 and 7, but the MSB at the bottom, hence we have to write 7, 13, 3. Okay, but 13 is the decimal number, we have to place hexadecimal equivalent of the 13, that is D. That means in that this conversion, we get the number 7D3. We get the number 7D3. Similarly, we can convert, or now we have to convert fractional part. We know the procedure very well. First of all, write the number 0.31, then multiply by its base, we get the number 4.96. Place the carry outside 4, the remaining number is 0.96. 0.96 is again multiplied by 16, and the process is continue up to till 5th position. Okay, now we have the carry 4, 15, 5, 12, 2. The hexadecimal equivalent of 15 is F and 12 is C. Hence, we get the number 4F5C2. 4F5C2. Then combine the result of these two conversion, we get the number 73.454F5C2. Okay, I hope you all understand how to convert the decimal number into its equivalent other number system. Now let's see the next type, binary to other conversion. First of all, let's see binary to octal conversion and binary to hexadecimal conversion. The steps of the binary to octal conversion are, note down the given binary number. The next step is group the bits, binary bits, into groups of 3. Okay, we have to make the group of 3 starting from LSB. Then last step is convert each 3 groups into its equivalent octal. It is very simple. Let's see it on an example. Binary to octal conversion, convert the binary number 11010010 into its equivalent number. First of all, write down the number 11010010. Then group it into the 3 bits such as 010. Okay. 010. Okay. 11. Here is the third bit is absent, hence we place it 0. Then convert this group into its decimal or octal equivalent. We know that 010 is decimal 2, 010 is decimal 2, and 011 is 3. Now place together this 322. Okay. Now we get the equivalent number as 322. Let's see it on another example. Convert the binary number 1001.0110 into its equivalent number. First of all, write down the number 1001.0110. Okay, now we have to make the group of 3 bits. The left hand side of the binary number, we make 3 group of 3 bits 100. That means this group, and the next is this group 1. The 2 zeros must be added to complete the group of 3. Okay, similarly we can make the 3 groups at right hand side like this. Okay, 011 and 000. We have to add 2 zeros at the right hand side of the decimal number. Okay, then the group first represents the decimal 0, group second is 011, represents decimal 3, group 3 represents 001, equivalent to decimal 1, group 4 represents 001, represents decimal 1. That means we got the number 11.30. Okay, now let's see binary to hexadecimal conversion. It is very simple that in octal conversion we have to make group of 3, but in hexadecimal we have to make group of 4. Let's see it on example. Convert the binary number 1001011110. then it is very simple. Make the group of four like this. Okay, write down the number, then make the group of four. The first group is 0111 and its equivalent hexadecimal is E. The next group is 0101, its equivalent is 1, its equivalent is 5, and the next group is 0010 and its equivalent is 2. We get 25E. Okay. Similarly, let's see it on another example. This is a very long binary number. The process is very simple. Make the group of 4 like this. Okay. At right hand side, also make the group of 4. After grouping, we get the number as 1010, 110, 0101, 10. At right hand side, we get the group 1110, 1011, 1010, and 01. Okay, we have to place two zeros here and two zeros here to make the group of 4 bit. Now, write down the decimal hexadecimal equivalent. That means 0010, 0010 is equivalent to hexadecimal 2. 0101 is equivalent to the decimal 5. 1110, that means 1110 is equivalent to the decimal E. Hexadecimal E. 1010 is equivalent to the hexadecimal A. 1110 is equivalent to E. 1011, that means 1011 is equivalent to the hexadecimal B. Similarly, put the equivalent number and combine it together, we get the number 25EA.EBA4. Okay. Now, let's see the conversion hexadecimal to the binary conversion. The process is opposite that binary to hexadecimal conversion. That means if we have the hexadecimal number such as AB2.05D, then write the binary equivalent of A. The binary equivalent of A is 1010. Okay. Next, write the binary equivalent of B. The binary equivalent of B is 1011. Write the binary equivalent of 2. Binary equivalent of 2 is 0010. Similarly, write down the binary equivalent of this hexadecimal number and write down it one after one. We get the binary equivalent. I hope you all understand the interconversion between the number system. Thank you.